Hi there and welcome to the channel. I just wanted to do a quick introduction to the Jamstik 7. This is a new product by Zivix. It replaces the previous Jamstik, the Jamstik 5 or the Jamstik Plus. And just so you know a little bit about it, the original Jamstik came out and it was a totally new class of device intended to help people learn how to play guitar. And then also to serve as a tool for people that wanted to interact with electronic music, such as on the iPad with lower latency. And then also for the idea of guitarists having another way to input MIDI other than through a keyboard. So kind of a creative device. That first generation created a Wi-Fi network of its own. The second generation came out of nowhere. I was shocked when they released it. And they made it Bluetooth low energy so that it now connected to your device via Bluetooth instead of through a wireless connection. And now we're looking at a 7-fret device with a 12-fret device headed out in the future. Now, what are a few of the things that they've changed? Obviously, the body shape is a little different. This piece used to just protect the mechanisms underneath, whereas now you have an entirely functional piece. This device, the shininess here are all IR sensors on the previous version. Now there's an optical sensor here that senses the strings vibrating, which is pretty interesting. Otherwise, it's using the same basic kinds of strings. I noticed that they're color-coded now on the top. I don't think that the old ones were. They were just simple ball ends, which is kind of neat. And you can change those out, and you can change the tension if you feel like you need to. You can change the sensitivity of the strings. But this little cutout here for the strings originally had me a little surprised. I felt like it was a really narrow channel to play, particularly compared to the old Jamstik. But as you can see, it's a little bit smaller, but it's still functional. And really the big deal is they moved that D-pad from being a right-handed centered instrument to being a completely lefty or righty, depending on what you wanted to do, because the main controls are now on the top, and those are touch pads as well. And there's different functions on that, and I'll show you that on the recording. So what I'm doing right now is I'm recording on my iPad what I see on the screen at the same time that I'm interacting with the Jamstik 7 here. So again, I've been playing ukulele intensively for the past 3 years, so my guitar skills are not the greatest, but I just wanted to show some things, and if I have to, I can just stick on the last 4 strings and focus on those guys too. So, some other things that they changed. I really like that they changed the mount for the strap, and then also they have a accessory body that you can get so you can feel like you're holding a guitar on the bottom, which is a pretty neat idea, and a travel case and some other things that come with it, and that's pretty nifty. And again, the IR sensors are gone because you now have an optical sensor where this thing is glowing green to let you know that it's on. It has a single outward switch, which is a power switch, which is right there, and it's pretty much out of the way. You're not going to hit it or anything like that. And then it has a couple other mounting points. And then the other big change for me was the idea that this one now uses standard AA batteries, 4 of them, whereas the Jamstik Plus utilized a single lithium ion battery. And I can't pop that out of there right now, but that's in there. So that was a kind of surprise to me too. I did not know that. Weight-wise, the Jamstik 7 is very similar to the Plus and may even be a little bit lighter. And I believe it comes in as a little bit cheaper too. And just as a side note, if you didn't see my blog post the other day, there is now a educator, student, first responder, and military discount if you want to order a Jamstik 7 to learn on. So let's take a second and look at the iPad screen. Now this is just the Jamstik app. I'm not pulling up the Jam Tutor app right now. I'm just, again, this is a first look at what we're looking at here. So you have a main menu that just tells you some things. It allows you to play in background, which I would turn on if I was going to use another app, that sort of deal. But then as we go down, there's a way to change tuning with a digital capo. And if I wanted to go to ukulele tuning, then I would just shift up there, and then suddenly I should be in the key of C like a ukulele. And I shift it back. Then you have some options in terms of overlay. Now this, if I was teaching class guitar right now, as I used to when I taught high school, this would be phenomenal. This is one of the reasons why I wish we had a ukulele stick in addition to a jam stick, because I would love to teach with this particular screen. So again, as you put your fingers on the screen, so I'm going to put my finger on the 3rd fret 6th string, and see if I take it on and off, it goes like that. And then if I add other fingers, it shows them as well. So if I want to play the G chord, there you go. I can also, if I'm instructing students in a classroom setting, I can put on a chord overlay, and let's say that I want to teach them the G chord. I can pull that chord up and then teach them how to play that chord. Now, you can adjust the sensitivity of the Jamstik strings, and I am chalking up my missed strings to maybe breaking in strings and getting them a chance to play some more, because I've only used this device an hour or two at the most. I've played around with it with the Chromebook a little bit, but this is kind of cool. Great way to teach your students if you're teaching in a classroom setting, and this screen would be on in my room all the time when I was instructing on chords. And also, when I was teaching guitar, I bought a travel guitar, about $100, a Washburn Rover, so that I could move around the room without, you know, knocking over music stands and everything else, because we practiced in the orchestra room with our class guitar setting. This little thing I could take anywhere with me. So if I'd go back in time, this would definitely be something I'd give myself if I was teaching class guitar. And if you teach class guitar, I don't see why you would want to teach without it. Let's look at a couple other things here. There's this data pad setting so you can know what each of these do, and you can change the functions if you want to, which is pretty cool. So you can see that a couple of those buttons have no, they're not assigned to anything yet. And the one that's really interesting to me is the hammer-ons. And that was an early complaint of the first Jamstik, so they didn't have that. But check this out. I got to play the first string. So I'm doing hammer-ons and pull-offs. Now, again, it feels a little bit different. And again, I'm used to playing hammer-on and pull-offs on a ukulele, which I think is a little different with a nylon string than it is with a metal string, and particularly with an electric instrument. But those hammer-ons and pull-offs work. String bends aren't yet included, but the company's always looking at adding new things. So if you're a person that wants to add string bends, the Jamstik may not be the instrument for you at the moment, but you never know what it's going to do in the future. Continuing down, this is where you can change your picking sensitivity, and right now I have it turned to medium, even though originally it was a little bit higher, and I'm not sure if that means maximum picking sensitivity means that it's most sensitive being picked, or minimum means that it's the most sensitive to being picked. I'm not quite sure, so when I was playing around with it, minimum seemed to work best for me. Take it for what you will, I guess. And then it has some side effects here where you can set up some boxes and some different sounds and even change your amp right within the Jamstik app. So if you want just an instrument to play with, this also works on iPhone. You've got a Bluetooth connection to your phone. You can put your headphones in. The one thing I wouldn't do is run necessarily Bluetooth headphones, but I haven't really tried that yet with the iPhone. All of my work with the Jamstik has been directly into the Jamstik app so far, with a little bit of trying with Notion, and I'll go to that before I close out this video. Then they also have a store for some extra sounds that you can buy, and they're not very expensive, but you can get a whole bunch of different sounds to play with, and that's all good, and the things that were originally included are still there for me as a download, so that's kind of nice. I usually like playing with this 12-string acoustic sound. I'll go back to this chord view here. But there's a whole bunch of other things you can put in there. I like, you know, if you want to play sitar, I got in the right key. There we go. Strings are a little bit closer, and of course metal compared to what I'm used to lately with the ukulele. So it's kind of fun. You can change those sounds around. You can have a classical acoustic sound, you know, or whatever you're going to use, and just play with and learn. Now again, they do include Jam Tutor, and I was talking with the company, and they made a really good point, which is there's at least 15 lessons included. Whereas if you bought the Jamstik, you get those 15 lessons, and by the time you're done with 15 lessons, you're ready for full-out guitar instruction with a trained instructor with such a good, solid head start that you don't waste those first lessons just learning some, you know, just basic chords like the G chord or the E minor chord or whatever. You know, you've already got that behind you, and then you can really make progress faster. And really, if you think about how much lessons are, I think they're generally $45 a half hour right now. It doesn't take too long before those 15 lessons and the added games and all the other features really add up to making the instrument itself worth the purchase price just for the software. And then the possibility to have something that you can play with quietly in the house. So like right now, I'm recording at night. My two boys are in bed and my wife is asleep, but she gets up at 4:30 in the morning. So I could put in my headphones and play all night long without anybody hearing me. And that would be a real benefit. A little harder to play on a plane. I see Kevin Honeycutt doing that all the time where he's playing on a plane. But I think the sounds on the string would drive people crazy after a while. But I really like what they've done. The company just, it's just amazing to me. They just continue to set this high bar for what are you going to do next with a Bluetooth MIDI device. And with the Chrome, they have a whole Chrome app. Play.jamstik.com will take you to their free services there, where if you have a Jamstik, you can use that interface on any device almost and use your Jamstik with it. Again, as usual, a wired connection with a Mac or a Chromebook is going to work better with Bluetooth than Bluetooth LE. And I'm not even sure that all Chromebooks have Bluetooth LE yet, although you can get some dongles that will work with them. And that's pretty cool. So let's take 1 second and look at Notion as well. I'm going to switch over to Notion, and I'm going to create a new document. I'll just call it Untitled 3. That's fine. Sorry for the delay here. Then I'm going to add guitar. So I'm going to go to guitar, and I will just call it acoustic guitar. And we've got that created, and I'm good to go here. So if I choose the note length, and I'm just going to choose quarter notes, let's see what happens. So I'm going to play the third string there. Open. And so forth and so on. Now I have noticed that chords don't necessarily translate well into Notion. You can see what happens with the tab there. But individual notes seems to work pretty well. And I'm pretty happy with that. So if I was going to be writing something in on guitar, I'd be set to go. It doesn't work, unfortunately, so well if I translate to ukulele and shift up, but that's okay. For those of you that are looking for a guitar interface to MIDI, you can see how that generally works really well until I get to the chords. And I'm not quite sure what to do with that yet. But then again, I'm not sure that I'm necessarily representative of what people would want to be doing with tablature like that. So, I think that's a pretty in-depth introduction to the Jamstik 7. I need to live with it a little while longer before I give you more feedback. Jam Tutor used to be a wonderful app. I'm sure it still is. I just haven't used it yet with this. I did play some of the games on play.jamstik.com, and those were kind of fun. So, if you are interested in one of these, educators in particular, using them in your classroom, and you teach guitar, you need to get yourself one of these. Check with your PTA. Go out and buy some of my favorite Ozark Delight lollipops and sell them and get yourself one of these for your program because it will help you teach. And that's not even getting into the whole idea of individualized education for some students that either are advanced and need to be pushed beyond what you're doing in your classroom guitar setting, or for the student that is falling behind. And let's say you have a rare situation, even in another program at the middle or high school level, where you have a student that is put into a band or a choir class, that would never happen, and they were acting up in class. When you talked to them, you found out what they really wanted to do is play guitar. Well, you might be able to work out with your administration that they could use a Jamstik and an iPad and, you know, lock them into that app and have them learning guitar instead of causing problems in your class. It's another idea if that student is open to that. So lots of possibilities for this, but as a teaching tool, the ability to be portable. I walked all upstairs to our bedroom before wearing it and downstairs again, and it didn't lose a connection. So if it can make it through the walls of our house and everything else, there's no reason why it can't make it all the way through your classroom. Just wonderful next step in technology, the Jamstik 7. So again, there is now an educator discount. There is now a student discount. There is now a first responder discount and a military discount for this device.